All right, Andrea, obviously we're here in San Salvador, just a day or so before the next encounter. You've become a regular fixture now in the national team. The coaches continue to show faith in you. And it's a chance now for players like yourself to step up. You probably now would be the leading forward on the team in terms of experience. And how do you see it going into Wednesday's game against El Salvador?
I see it's a good game, a good competitive game for me and the rest of the players. Seeing that we played them already in the Gold Cup and seeing we know how to play and we'll be able to fit in to our status. A lot of us went to the Gold Cup that is on the team right now, so it will be a good game.
They are coming off a 2-0 result at Costa Rica, which is a good result obviously. And we haven't played as such since the Gold Cup. Some new faces in the team as well. How do you see the challenge of getting these guys to mesh together? And some of them probably going to have some jitters being on international stage for the first time. They are accustomed playing at the pro league level, and you for one, you know now that it's a different level totally from pro league to international football. There's a gap there. You've grown accustomed to that now. How you intend to pass that on to the rest of the team?
It's a good experience being with the club that I went in the A-League and seeing that they had to work hard and step it up in the game and everything. And them players and them right now who join us, I feel they have a little confidence seeing that they're with us, like players who went to the Gold Cup and playing with us. They have a little bit of confidence and they look sharp, but not like 100%, but they'll be able to give like 80% in the game.
Alright. And you in particular, as you rightly said, the experience with Charleston would have done a great deal for you. Tell us a bit about how that season went.
It was good at the start when I reached, the first game I played.
You got a goal, you scored, yeah.
And set up one. Second one I had set up, and then I played like 5 games. Scored one, set up 2. It was kind of difficult, coach had me playing on the right. Left, sometimes in field. Yeah, no playing all over, but it was a good experience seeing that I played most of the games that I went up there to play, and it was not to play it. The players on them they was very nice to me, and I was comfortable and everything, and my intensity level was good and everything, but as I come back here, kind of get sloppy, and by this game here, I don't know how fit this level is and everything.
Why is that though? Because of the fact that you think you're returning back to the Pro League, you tend to drop your wings a little bit?
Nah, not that. That is the Pro League, but it's just when I come back, I had 2 weeks off.
Yeah, okay.
So I was hardly training and stuff.
Yeah. All right, and particularly for you now, your ambitions, obviously, that little stint with Charleston has increased your appetite now for professional football on a whole. Are you prepared now? Are you looking forward to probably returning to Charleston or even getting something elsewhere for the next season?
Well, I've talked to my agent, and she said, I'll return back there, early in the season, and, midway in the season, she will look somewhere else, somewhere in Europe.
And this is the same agent for the Robots as well?
Yeah.
Okay. You know at Derby Connection, how you see the setup there, how would you compare, obviously there are going to be differences because of the fact that in our Pro League, still in a stage where we growth and development is a major factor right now, and we're still in the early stages when you compare with some of the other leagues outside. But how would you compare the setup at Derby Connection as to a club like Charleston?
Charleston, you can say it more professional and organized. All the Derby Connection, they're trying to reach at that level. But it is a small Caribbean team, and yeah, it will take time. But Charleston are a very professional team, and they have been doing a lot of things, having their own field and stuff. Good turf, everything, and
they try to make it comfortable for the players. Everything is about the players, about the team.
Everything is about the players and stuff. And Derby Connection is not too far, but it's just that players had to know they had to come out to work and make up their mind to do what the coach want them to do and to be comfortable now.
Yeah.
So it's not all that far.
The coach in particular, our head coach has kept on saying that, you know, while it's good for these new faces to get that experience, and he's left the door open to a lot of players to come in into the team to try out before we actually get into that World Cup qualification phase again next year. He has stressed the importance of having more experienced players around so that the lesser experienced ones can gain from that. But what do you think about that? How you look forward to, you know, probably getting some of the more regular faces back into the national team so that, you know, you could obviously, you know, take off of them as well?
It's very hard, like, for the local players to come and play with the foreign players, because the foreign players will not, like, step down to our level. The local players have to step up to their level.
And that's a challenge, obviously.
That's a challenge, and
it makes you a better player in the end, don't you think? You in particular, you've had a chance to line up with the big guns before. You just recently, last year after the World Cup, you had a chance to go to Australia, where we had some of the regular players on the so-called blacklist that they were present in that game. And I'm sure that would have done a whole lot for you.
Yeah, it's done a lot for me. They see the level is more intense too when you play with them. So you will have to improve sooner or later once you keep on playing at that level.
And now that you're with a bunch that, you know, includes most of the local base, you see yourself as somebody who could try to convince his players that, you know, this is what we need to do, this is the level we need to play at if we want to be successful professional players.
Yeah, I talked to some of them and say that the level that we have to play at is a fast level, and it'll be very intense, and everybody has to come out and work hard and prepare to make up their mind to do what the coach wants.
Yeah, and what can we expect from Andre to say for the next, you know, the short term, 2 to 3 years? Obviously you have a lot of high goals set for yourself.
Just expect more performance and more in everything that I wasn't doing before. Discipline and everything else.
Great. All the best.